So in the background here, I got Deja Vu from E.Z. McCoy playing the background. I'm going to talk about the film Tetris. Yeah, so like the format of this like film is kind of really traditional. Like, it's like kind of a feel-good like sort of comedy drama, but like ultimately it's a sort of a thriller. Yeah, it's about Tetris. So let's just get straight to the premise. Tells us the unbelievable story of how one of the world's most popular games found its way to players around the globe. Hank Rogers discovers Tetris in 1988 and then risks everything by traveling to the Soviet Union, where he joins forces with inventor Alexei Azitnov to bring the game to the masses. And it's based on a true story. Tetris is a Cold War era thriller on steroids with double-crossing villains, unlikely heroes, and a nail-biting race to the finish. This film, like, the way it's shot, I mean, the way, like the plot moves, like, it really progresses when it comes to tension. Because the film starts off, like, really, like, a lightweight comedy. But then, like, man, when they bring in more characters and more, and there's more, like, betrayals and people with motivations that were established in the beginning on the surface level are actually fake motivations, and like this film has an interesting take when it comes to the concept of the truth and being honest, and they integrate it very well with the backdrop of the fall of the Soviet Union, because this story, yeah, it does take place in 1988. And I really don't want to like spoil any more than that. I mean, because even though this film is almost like a business movie, where like, yeah, like a kind of a young like business-minded person, like will like go up and like, you know, go beyond Call of Duty to like, you know, I don't know, make a good business. But at the same time, it's a really good thriller when it comes to that Cold War era aspect of the film. So. Because I don't really play Tetris. I've played it a few times, but I definitely don't love it or play it a lot. So that's like the draw, I think, on the surface. But like, there's a lot of surprising like emotional depth, especially at the end. Like there's a really good surprise. Like, for, you know, I don't know, when it comes to character interactions, and yeah, ultimately though, it does end up. But yeah, it's a happy ending. I mean, this is like, again, like a mainstream like film and marketed as that. Yeah, so this is Radar. Came out this year. It's about 2 hours long. And I definitely recommend it if you're into Cold War thrillers. Not even much about like Tetris itself. Tetris is like kind of a plot device to keep the plot going. But I guess if you like Tetris and you're interested in its history, yeah, I mean, definitely not a, you know, a minute by minute truth telling and reenactment of the formation of how Tetris became available to everyone in the world, but you know, based on a true story. From the background here, I got playing Someday by One Republic, and I'm just gonna close off this review for Tetris. Until then, take it easy. Peace.